Hey guys, welcome to Gamentor, this is Das here. Today Gamentor have with 5 things you need to know about Hitman 2016 game. This was a combination of things we learned from various bits of information about the game and spending a lot of time with the beta. So let's get started by number 5. The new Hitman is doing a lot of interesting things in terms of how you kill your target. What I enjoyed most from beta is ability to blend in certain situations, like as bartender or waiter. You have the ability to walk up to a bar and activate a promt, allowing you to start working at the bar and blending in. It's kind of like an assassin script when you're sitting on a bench or blending in with the crowd, but it's a little more believable here. Also, another thing we picked up that is very cool is that the ability to actually walk up and talk to your target in disguise and trick them. You can lure them in certain situations through some karisma. In situation in beta, you can disguise yourself as a mechanic and rig something to explode, and in disguise, you can lure your target over to the rig device citing a manual sefety inspection. The target in this case believed your story and went along until the prime moment when you could take him out. In terms of changing your disguise and having your identity, it's very similar to the Hitman Absolution, but it's a little more subtle. This time around, people still do recognize you, but usually just mean term like a hierarchy sentence. Almost like there are different classes. For example, chefs aren't gonna recognize different mechanics, but some police are gonna recognize other police officers. It's a little cheesy, but it's not always believable, but it does add nice little bit of challenge. And it's good way to scan a crowd and decide how you're gonna navigate through it. And number 4, in this new Hitman, you're gonna be able to pick your weapon and load out before you start a mission. This wasn't present in the beta, but apparently this is gonna be the final feature in the game, and I'm pretty into that. Because one of my favorite aspects of Hitman 2 Silent Assassin was being able to go Agent 47 woodshed and pick your weapon off the wall and start a mission with it. That's kind of an open-ended level of choice, and what kind of weapon you want to use to do the job, or you wanna bring any weapons at all. It's kind of what makes Hitman special. I'm very happy that it's making its way into this game. Also, one thing we did pick up from the beta is that the weapon selection is pretty slick. The last few Hitman games has looked very nicely, so this time around the menu is just completely simple. You press a button on the D-pad, it brings up weapons, you swing through them, select it, that's it, done. Maybe it's a little too simple for some people, but I like the way it looks. And the number 3. Something you definitely need to know about new Hitman is that save states are back. This meaning you can save anytime, anywhere during a mission before killing your target. This goes back to the old style of Hitman system from Blood Money and the games before that. This is a very welcoming thing that was pretty much missing from Absolution, and fans of this series really wants it back. Now this time around, you will be able to have plenty of different save states while you're doing a mission. If you wanna go back and reload and try something else, you're free to do so. And in number 2, something very important in this new Hitman game you need to know is that the levels are absolutely huge. According to developer, each map in this game is apparently 6 to 7 times larger than the largest level in the Hitman Absolution. And I wanna say, that's exactly what I wanna hear. This is to give the player the absolute complete sandbox style of game, and how they are gonna choose to kill their target. The fact that these new levels are huge calls exactly to the amount of freedom in this game and the variety of kills you're going to have. I spoke about it earlier about new ways to blend in and ways to load your target around, but this time around in this Hitman game have ton more ways to uniquely kill your target. Just from the super short beta has a bunch of stuff like drowning your target in the toilet, shooting them in the face, choking them out, rigging a jet to explode, also dropping a lifeboat on someone's head. Hitman games always known for variety, but this time around it's like they are taking sandbox to the next level. I really hope that's true. From the beta I could get the idea, but I'm hoping it's not just a marketing buzzword. Speaking of marketing buzzwords, let's talk about number 1. This new Hitman is going for a more episodic style of game, and it's very confusing to a lot of people. But the developers are not calling episodic, they're calling it platform. So let me try and break it down. On launch in March, the game will contain just a prologue mission and the first big sandbox map, that being Paris. Now apparently in this style, the developers are hoping that the levels are so massively huge. By including a couple of story assassination, each level will definitely will get its money back. Not only that, you can play this level in a free from mode, going back and try different things, accomplishing different goals, checking of different boxes and different ways to accomplishing missions and assassinate someone. The developers are also hoping by the time you tired of Paris, the other two cities of the main game, Sapienza and Marrakesh, will be released in April and May of 2016, with 3 more levels releasing later in this year. By the end of 2016, apparently Hitman is going to get the full disc release, but developers keep using the word platform. To really emphasize how this game going to be out, they are going to be adding new features, adding new levels over time, so it's kind of just a growing thing. I still can't figure that out. This is a weird money grab or just an interesting way to make a Hitman game on the budget or in a shorter amount of time. I don't know what they are going for, but thankfully the core game is really good. Time will test. I guess we have to be judge of the game when it's finally released. But I'll say the prologue missions are definitely have some promises. Seems like it is doubling down on the story and the content of the game. Rolling out in the prologue when you first see Agent 47 introduced to Diana in the agency due training. It's kind of cool. Also referencing back to the original Hitman game, something I did not expect. So I'm still a little skeptical and hopeful for this game. Those are very 5 things you definitely need to know about this new Hitman game going in. I also think you need to know that instinct mode that was really so heavily upon absolution is definitely toned down a bit this time around. There's still gonna be a bunch of different things like contract mode, and also David Bateson, the voice actor of Agent 47, does return, and this is definitely welcome return, I gotta say. But guys, most importantly, I wanna know in the comment section, what do you guys think about this new Hitman game? If you have got your hand on the beta and playing it, what do you think about this? Yeah, I know it's very simple and very short. Do you get how to think about this game? Let me know in the comment section. You can also talk to me on Twitter at @tapos714. Let us know anything you know in the comment section about Hitman series. If you guys did like this video and wanna see more Hitman videos, click in the like button, that helps us a lot. And if this is your first time here, a subscription is a great option because we put out videos every single day of the week. But as always, thank you guys for watching this video. We'll see you guys next time.